you doing, Chaim? Tell us the story of Tsfaz, the story of peace and love.
Well, I was out on the Psoim, trying to put the filling on people a couple months ago. And yeah. I was walking through the art district, and I saw this kid with the shirt, and it said Quagga on it. And I know Quagga, that's a camp in North Wisconsin by the camp, the rival camp that I went to. And I said, hey, I went to Menominee. I started talking to them, and I said I was from Deerfield, and they said they were from Deerfield. Deerfield, and I turned next to me, Deerfield, Illinois.
Deerfield, Illinois?
Yeah, and I turned next to me, and I saw my fourth grade teacher, Mrs. Lynn.
Right.
That was pretty wild, this little Ashkafa Pratis for Divine Providence right here in Tzfat. The odds of that happening, kind of, I don't know, I guess it was meant to be.
Is she Jewish?
She's Jewish, yeah. Right. She belongs to my shul back at home.
Okay. And that's pretty cool. And you're studying Tanya a little bit, Chassidus?
Study Tanya. We have Tanya Shir every day at 6:15.
Which yeshiva is this?
The Baal Teshuva Yeshiva here in Tsfaz, Timi Medar, Rabbi Pashnak, Rabbi Gornstein, Rabbi Galitzan. It's an awesome program. Anyone who's looking for a yeshiva, who's never been to yeshiva before, you gotta come to Tsfaz. Come to our yeshiva, Timi Medar.
Timi Medar.
Timi Medar.
And did you do outreach for all people over here, the Seven Laws of Noah?
We try. There's a lot of people who come on Birthright and they come to Tsfaz to find spirituality, to try to get close to God. And a lot of these people come on Birthright, they aren't Jewish, according to Jewish law. So it's kind of interesting. I've been meeting a lot of people, and it's hard to kind of have this conversation with them to say, like, you know, you're not Jewish, even though you think you are. But yeah, it's still a good opportunity to tell people about the Sheva Mitzvahs of Noah.
Right.
And
connect
to my best.
Go ahead, play us a tune. Chaim again?
Yeah.
Chaim, go ahead. No.
Okay, hi, I'm here in Tsfaz in the famous gallery of
Souza Kohn.
Yeah. As you can see, the magnificent, the beautiful work. Take a shot of some of the work over here. And this is originally from England?
Yeah.
From London, right?
Yeah, Londonian.
And she's not just an artist herself, she's obviously a mother of a beautiful artist by his son's name is?
Shlomo.
Shlomo did a beautiful painting, which I just got, of the Rebbe. And as you can see, it's Shlomo Kohn.
Which he made when he was 16.
When he was 16.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
we're going to go see his work.
Okay. So, tell us about what you're trying to express over here. Judaism, Torah?
For sure, yeah, but I think that, like, my spiritual journey began in a very kind of unconscious way. I didn't really realize that it even was a spiritual journey. I come from a family of artists. My father was a painter, and so I just, like, painting was just always around me. So I've just always been painting, but I didn't really realize. And now I unrolled this painting, for example,
right,
after 20 years of having made it. I made it before I had Shlomo. Shlomo's like 19 now. This is before I had him. I painted it a couple of years before I had him. And I see that it's like a story, it's a biography, it's biographical, but at the same time there's this kind of mysterious green figure in the background. Mm-hmm. Who's that? I know it's not, but it's my expression of Hashem, that Hashem is there, like, underpinning behind everything, this kind of, like, immense, like, love and warmth and embrace. It's, like, amazing to me that I didn't know anything. I came from a completely assimilated secular family. My grandfather unfortunately changed his name from Cohen to Christian. I shut the name back. And Souza was my father's name.
And your father's a famous artist?
Yeah, but my father wasn't Jewish, my father was a Gentile.
Right.
From India.
From India.
He's called the Indian Picasso. You can Google him, F.N. Souza.
F.N.?
Souza.
Souza.
Yeah, the name of the gallery is Souza Kohn.
Souza. F.N. Souza.
Yeah.
S-O-U-Z-A. S-O-U-Z-A. And the spiritual journey took you all the way from India to London back
then? No, I was born in London. My mother was a Holocaust survivor from Prague.
Right.
She was a Bas Cohen. But again, she grew up completely assimilated. So really, my son, bless him, is the first person
Cohen.
In our family, Shlomo, to... He's not strictly halakhically a Cohen,
right.
But he is the first male... First of all, he's the firstborn son. That's the first time for like four generations. And secondly, he is the... And firstly, again, two firsts. He's the first one to wear tefillin for four generations.
Wow.
So it's a really massive bridge, and it's all credit goes to the Rebbe, Melech HaMashiach. Because I am like one of those crazy Baal Teshuvas who is raving Mashiachist, who never ever had the fabulous experience of actually seeing the Rebbe in his guf. And I can't believe it. If somebody like 20 years ago told me, you know what, you're going to be an Orthodox Jew and you're going to believe in God and, you know, and you're going to be a mother, and I would have just like, I don't know, pushed them over or something.
I grew up actually with the Rebbe and McCohen, and I actually had the experience to meet him several times, and I could see that, you know,
it's amazing.
Please God, we should see that day when...
And then the Rebbe brought, you know, then like, so I had all of that, and if that wasn't enough, you know, to have been given my two blessed diamonds, you know, to be entrusted, I have a magnificent daughter. She made the doll there and the jewellery there.
What's her name?
Her name's Miriam.
Miriam.
Yeah, and both of the names are like complete Ruach HaKodesh, you know,
right.
Because I didn't know anything about anything, totally nothing. It's all like beautifully embroidered and everything. She's really blossoming. She's amazing. And I don't know what else to say, really.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, I know. I was going to say that I have the amazing merits to be brought here to this unbelievably holy city of Tsfaz, which is not only, you know, I daven from an Ari Siddur, which
right.
is the Lubavitch Siddur, and the Ari is here.
See, right.
And there's this extraordinary, amazingly beautiful Chabad community here in Tsfaz. The Rebbe sent 8 shluchim here 8 years ago when there was like a desert. A religious desert. There was like nothing going on here, and now it's a thriving, beautiful Chabad community. And what else? And there's Chabad, and there's art.
Tsfaz
has like tons of art. It has like artists. It's always been like a magnet for artists and for Kabbalah. And so it's like whatever. I'm very
into mystical.
Yeah, that's it.
So you're fusing. You're trying to express the spiritual onto a physical canvas.
Yeah, Hashem, I think so, I guess so, yeah. I don't know, I have more successful days than others.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Welcome, you should enjoy Tsfaz. Yeah.
Okay, Sunny, this is Shlomo's work.
Yeah, it goes by Sunny, Shlomo.
The Aleph in the middle. Wow.
This is us, but yeah. I just want to just explain this quickly. See, this is a painting. He's a great mural artist. He makes loads of paintings on the walls in Nachle Art. We can give you our website. And
the website
are two films of him.
What's his website?
The gallery website is www.souzakohngallery.com.
Souza, how do you spell that?
S-O-U-Z-A.
S-O-U-Z-A-K-O-H-N. K-O-H-N, okay.
Yeah. And there's these two little movies on there. And you'll see him walking through the
streets
of Nachle Art. That's
a self-portrait,
yeah.
Wow, powerful.
So this is a painting of the heart that he made. It's chained down here. The heart's chained down. And then he came to Tsfaz, and one of the first things he did was he made this. And he calls this, what does he call it? Ideological...
And that's
ideological
that's a mural.
Revolutionaries.
And that's
so this
it.
Is like this is like the sequel to it.
Okay, we're here with...
I'm going to give you a
cap. You're here we're with Bonkers the Clown.
That's right, from Toronto, Canada.
From Toronto, Canada, who does... What, his Hebrew name is?
Shane Appiah.
Shane Appiah.
Okay. And this is for you.
Thank you.
Forget your name. My Rabbi. It is. It's a lovely name.
Oh, Rabbi Cohen.
Rabbi Cohen. Oh.
Yeah. You're going to be on TV.
I'm going to be on TV, yeah.
In New York.
I believe that when I see it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, everybody.
What
Rabbi
do you want
Cohen.
To say? Stay safe.
You and me making a kefir, a little dog before Shabbat. Have a good Shabbos, everybody.
And you do work in
Toronto, Canada.
You help out kids.
I do shows in Canada. I work in senior homes there.
Volunteer work.
We do 3 days a week. The shul is open in a senior home. And a few guys, we run the service.
Right. And look at this beautiful talisman behind you, Mrs. Zod.
Lovely, look at them.
Look at you.
Come to Israel and buy.
And buy, Zagazin.
Zagazin.
Hi, everybody. Here we are with Rabbi Cohen.
From
and we've met some lovely girls from Argentina.
Shabbos. Welcome to One People.
Welcome to Tsfaz, my friend. What's your name?
My name is Rabbi Cohen. You are?
I'm Yitzhak.
Yitzhak, show us.
Welcome to Tsfaz Gallery. Over here we have artists from all over Israel, not just from Tsfaz, that we collect for 25 years. You can see modern and classic art combined together.
Okay.
You can see Judaica,
okay, let's see
art, and you can see over here an artist named Yossi Cohen, which is Yossi Biton, sorry.
Biton.
He's an artist that Chazal b'Tshuva.
Yeah.
He has a very, very different...
This is his work over here?
This is him. This is work by Yossi Biton. He actually took things from what he saw in the past, what he from his head, and put it inside a painting, which is very, very unique and strong, I think.
And he lives here in Tsfaz?
He lives in Jerusalem.
Jerusalem.
He used to live in Tsfaz. He was born and raised in Tsfaz. Loves it. Now he lives in Jerusalem. Look at this painting over here.
Which one? It's a child?
The child is looking at a butterfly, which is Malabu Masech Hashem.
Which means?
He's amazed by the butterfly. A very, very simple thing, but it's also very strong. That's the main idea of this.
And behind you we have the...
Behind us we have the Jerusalem by Gendelman. The lady Gendelman. She is an artist that used to live in Tsfaz for a year. She is from Ukraine originally. Come to Israel with a group of artists. Her specialty is strong colors, and she become paints Jerusalem and Tsfaz Alice. You can see over here behind the Talitot. That's it. She become really popular in style.
This is a Talit. This is a Talit.
Talitot are made by different artists from Israel. Handmade work, design work. It's Judaica work.
And your name again is?
Yitzchak.
Ben Porat. And
I say hello to everybody in Brooklyn, New York.
In America, in New York, New York. And Mashiach now, we should...
Mashiach now,
Bezat Shem. We should see the Geula Amitis Vashlema.
From your mouth to God, you know?
And you do you put on the tefillin.
Now I put a tefillin, this is my friend over here.
What's his friend? What's his name? Shmuel.
He's my Rebbe.
Your Rebbe, Shmuel.
Every Friday here, putting a tefillin on for me.
And Bezat Hashem, you're going to start doing it?
Bezat Hashem, I'm hoping so.
Shalom.
Shalom, Elitot.
And Elitot, welcome. Shalom. is the famous end today. Shalom.
Hello, Shalom Aleichem.
No.
Was macht man? Baruch Hashem.
Yeah.
Me wart auf Mashiach do in Tsfaz.
Yeah. Me greit, me greit. Can I know? Look at Peter. Shalom.
Yeah, it's a video, no? Tell us.
Can I get fun with that video, Yanko?
No.
אמן.
We're here in Tsfaz, go ahead. What's your name?
Yosef. My name is Chasson, Yosef David. I'm an Ole Chadash.
And tell us the words, some story.
Words of Torah?
The words of Torah.
In the merit of our righteous women, we were redeemed from Mitzrayim, and in the merit of our righteous women, we were redeemed here and now.
Amen.
The Mashiach Tzidkenu immediately.
Amen. Well, what's your name?
Moshe.
Moshe. You're learning over here in Tzemach Tzedek?
Learning here in Tzemach Tzedek.
What are you learning?
We're learning Chassidus, we're flying high, but yeah. we're bringing it down, back to the earth, bringing the heavens down here.
Any stories you like to share? We just had the Chof Bei Shvat, the Fabringen yesterday.
Yeah.
How was it? My mother is outside.
Long stories.
How long?
10 minutes.
No, 10 minutes. You know. Okay, Moshe. Shalom from Tsfaz.
Shalom aleichem. I hope that's editing.
Here we are. Again.
Yay! Nice to talk to you. Your father was here just over a week ago for the Bris Mila of Shalom Pasternak's son Yosef. Not named after you, but named after probably who you're named after. Named after the Friedrich Rebbe. And I miss you, buddy. When are you coming to Tsfaz? Shechina is here. We need to be in Tsfaz so that Mashiach can take us to Yerushalayim immediately. Hope to talk to you soon. All the best. Yeah. Hatzlacha Rabbah on the Upper East Side.
And connect
to my best.
Go ahead, play us a tune. Chaim again?
Yeah.
Chaim, go ahead. No.
Okay, hi, I'm here in Swat within the famous gallery of
Souza Kohn.
Yeah. As you can see the beautiful work. Take a shot of some of the work over here. And this is originally from England?
Yeah.
From London, right?
Yeah, Londonian.
And she's not just an artist herself, she's obviously a mother of a beautiful artist by his son's name is?
Shlomo.
Shlomo, and here's Shlomo. Shlomo has did a beautiful painting, which I just got, of the Rebbe. And as you can see, it's Shlomo Kohn.
Which he made when he was 16.
When he was 16. Okay, so
we're going to go see his work.
Okay. So, tell us about what you're trying to express over here, Judaism, Torah.
For sure, yeah, but I think that like my spiritual journey began in a very kind of unconscious way. I didn't really realize that it even was a spiritual journey. I come from a family of artists. My father was a painter, so I just like painting was just always around me. So I've just always been painting, but I didn't really realise. And now I unrolled this painting, for example,
right.
After 20 years of having made it. I made it before I had Shlomo. Shlomo's like 19 now. This is before I had him. I painted it a couple of years before I had him. And I see that it's like it's a biography, it's biographical, but at the same time there's this kind of mysterious green figure in the background. Mm-hmm. Who's that? I know it's not, but it's my expression of Hashem, that Hashem is there, like, underpinning behind everything, this kind of, like, immense, like, love and warmth and embrace. It's, like, amazing to me that I didn't know anything. I came from a completely assimilated secular family. My grandfather, unfortunately, changed his name from Cohen to Christian. And so I shut the name back, Carter. Mm. And Souza was my father's name.
And your father's a famous artist?
Yeah, but my father wasn't Jewish, my father was a Gentile.
Right.
From India.
He's
called the Indian Picasso. You can Google him, F.N. Souza.
F.N.?
Souza.
Souza.
Yeah, and the name of the gallery is Souza Kohn.
Souza. F.N. Souza.
Yeah.
S-O-U-Z-A. S-O-U-Z-A. And the spiritual journey took you all the way from India to London, back
then? No, I was born in London. My mother was a Holocaust survivor from Prague.
Right.
She was a bus Cohen.
Amen. 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 Amen
Yeah.